Everyone loves eggs for breakfast. Now let's see all the amazing ways Rolly can make breakfast exciting. Let's start with our basic Rolly eggs that are perfect for a quick meal any morning. First, spray the Rolly chamber with a non-stick cooking spray. And you're gonna wanna do that for every recipe using the Rolly Egg Master. Then crack one or two large eggs directly into the chamber. For over hard eggs, cook for approximately 6 to 8 minutes or until the egg pops up from the cooking chamber. If you want softer eggs, you can do that too. Simply pour the eggs out after 5 minutes. And this is your delicious basic Rolly egg. For something a little healthier, you can make Rolly egg whites. Just separate egg whites from 3 large eggs, or you can use egg whites from the carton, and you can find these in the refrigerated section of your grocery store. Next, pour the egg whites directly into the chamber. There you go. And approximately 6 to 8 minutes, the eggs should pop up, and you can simply pour them out of the cooking chamber. And that's how you make healthy Rolly egg whites. Now let's do something a little different. Let's try our Rolly egg crackers. In a medium bowl, crumble 5 round crackers and add 1/8 cup of your favorite cheese. I'm gonna use cheddar. Next, crack 1 large egg into the bowl, and then you could add salt and pepper, however amount that you like to taste. And then you're just gonna gently stir it all together. Once it's stirred, you just pour the mixture into the chamber. And you're gonna go ahead and cook this for approximately 5 to 6 minutes. Now, if you like a crispier egg, you can turn your Rolly upside down and place it back into the Rolly cooker for about 2 minutes. And that's the Rolly egg crackers. Now, for a little extra oomph to your eggs, you can crack 1 egg into the chamber. Then, using a wooden skewer, stick 4 or 5 small cubes of feta cheese about 1/2 inch apart. Do you love bacon and eggs or sausage and eggs in the morning? No sweat. The Rolly Egg Master can do that too with the Rolly Bacon Egg and Rolly Eggling. Remember, always spray the Rolly cooking chamber with non-stick cooking spray before you start. Then crack 2 large eggs directly into the chamber. Now, thread a strip of pre-cooked bacon or pre-cooked sausage onto a skewer, and then go ahead and place the skewer into the cooking chamber. For the bacon, cook 6 to 8 minutes. And for the sausage, you can normally cook it from 5 to 7 minutes. And the egg will usually rise at that time, or you can just pour them out. And there you have the Rolly bacon egg. You can even use a thin hot dog for a Rolly egg dog the kids will love. Just crack an egg and pour it into the chamber. And then take your hot dog and put it on a skewer and then place it inside the cooking chamber. Just cook about 6 to 8 minutes and dinner is ready. For the Rolly egg in a blanket, simply roll up your favorite sliced meat, such as salami, turkey, or ham. I'm gonna go with salami. All you do is just roll it up and put it in the chamber. Then you're gonna crack 1 egg and add that into the chamber as well. How easy is that? Dinner ready? Rolly egg in a blanket. Have a craving for a delicious egg white omelet, but don't have the time to hover over a pan? No worries, then make a delicious Rolly veggie tortilla. In a bowl, we're going to mix 3 egg whites, I already have mine in, and 1 teaspoon each of red pepper, green pepper, some spinach, and onion. And then salt and pepper, whatever amount that you like in yours. I'm gonna put that all together, mix it up, and then grab your tortilla and just fold your tortilla over, put it into the cooking chamber. This is where you take your packer, go ahead and just push that down to make sure it's all the way down there. Grab your mixture, put that into the cooking chamber, and that's it. In just a few minutes, your tortilla is going to rise and your fiesta can begin. Look how delicious that looks. For a different type of tortilla, to the egg whites, you can add a quarter cup of thawed and drained chopped spinach and an eighth of a cup of crumbled feta cheese for a rolly Greek tortilla. For a yummy rolly breakfast burrito, mix in a bowl one large egg, and then one chopped pre-cooked sausage link. Put that in there. And one tablespoon of your favorite shredded cheese. So we're gonna mix that up. And if you're a bacon lover, you can easily add bacon into this recipe instead of sausage. All right, now we're going to take our tortillas again that we cut into our 4x6 rectangles. I'm gonna fold them up and then go ahead and put it right into the cooking chamber. Grab your packer and just make sure that goes all the way down there. Take your mixture, pour it right in. And in about 8 minutes, your burrito is ready. What a great way to start the day. For a fancy weekend brunch, why not try the smoked rolly tortilla? In a bowl, mix one large egg and one tablespoon smoked trout or salmon. I have salmon here today. Again, it's whatever you would like. And one tablespoon of goat cheese or feta. This is feta. And then you're going to use chopped onions. You can also use caramelized onions. Again, depending on your taste. And then salt and pepper, as much as you like. We like pepper, so we're going to use a little bit more than that. All right, now we're going to mix this all together. Give it a good mix so all the ingredients are mixed in perfectly together. And then we're going to take our tortilla. Now this is our 4x6 tortilla that we cut earlier. Roll it up, and we're going to put that into the cooking. Make sure it's all the way down there. Take your mixture. Go ahead and pour that all in there. There you go. And then in just 8 minutes, you have a perfect smoked rolly tortilla. Want something different for breakfast? How about the French toast rolly? All you're going to do is cut up two slices of white bread into small cubes, and that's what I have done here. Now you're gonna add one regular egg and then some vanilla extract, milk, cinnamon, and sugar. And mix it all together and let the mixture soak for a couple minutes until it becomes this consistency. Then go ahead and pour your mixture into the cooking chamber. Add a little bit at a time. And then this is where your packer is going to come in handy. So if you see that it's sitting on the top, you just take your packer and go ahead and push that down. All your mixture into there. And a good tip is you're gonna pack it to the top of the logo so it gives you something to look for so you know exactly the right amount. All right, I think we're almost there. I'm gonna use my packer just to make sure everything's packed in there. Perfect. Okay, now you're going to let that cook for about 5 to 6 minutes. Then you're gonna take your powdered sugar and your maple syrup and you're gonna drizzle it over. We like maple syrup, so we're gonna do a little bit more. There you go. And grab powdered sugar, sprinkle it on top. Oh, doesn't that look good? A wonderful breakfast.
Rolly even does pancakes. To make a rolly pancake link, pour a quarter cup of pancake batter into the cooking chamber. Then just place one pre-cooked sausage onto a wooden skewer and then place that into the center of the pancake batter. And then you're going to cook that for approximately 8 minutes and then pour the rolly pancake link out.
Oh, doesn't that look good?
Looking for something new for lunch, dinner, or even a party? Rolly doesn't stop at breakfast. Check out the pizza rolly and rolly pizza stick. As always, spray the rolly cooking chamber first with non-stick cooking spray. Then, for the pizza rolly, take two pieces of refrigerated biscuit dough and roll into a ball. Then lay the biscuit dough out flat on a surface and then flatten it into a thin circle, about 3 to 4 inches across. Then you're gonna spread a thin layer of pizza sauce. Put that all the way over. Then you're going to add your favorite toppings. Now, I chose pepperoni, but you can put whatever you like. Just add a few right there in the middle, and then go ahead and top it with your mozzarella cheese. Now, to me, no pizza is complete without Parmesan cheese, so I'm going to add a little bit there. Now, you're going to take your dough, and you're going to roll it very tightly so we can put it into our cooking chamber. Then, once it's rolled, go ahead and roll one side and pinch it. Now, that's the side you're going to put down into the cooking chamber. Now this is where your packer's gonna come in handy, so you can go ahead and pack this down into the cooking chamber. Now cook this for approximately 6 to 8 minutes, and then you have a beautiful pizza rolli. Or if you don't have any biscuit dough, try the rolli pizza stick. Cut a tortilla into a 4x6 rectangle. Then spread a thin layer of pizza sauce. Then you're going to add your favorite toppings. I'm going to use some pepperoni here. Then add your mozzarella cheese. No pizza is complete without a little oregano. Then add some salt and pepper. Now you're going to roll your tortilla. Roll it pretty tight. And you just take that and put it into the cooking chamber. You can use your packer just to make sure it's all the way down into the chamber. Now cook this for about 7 minutes. If you like a crispier crust, you can turn your rolli upside down and place it back into the rolli cooker for about 2 minutes. Then your rolli pizza stick is all set. Here's something I love to make for a party, the barbecue pork rolli. Just like the pizza rolli, take 2 pieces of refrigerated dough out and put it on a flat surface, and then flatten it into a thin circle about 3 to 4 inches across. Now you're gonna layer it with pre-cooked barbecue pork. This already smells so good. All right, so go ahead and put that. Now we're going to roll. So take the dough and go ahead and roll it towards you. Making it tight, and then you're gonna pinch one side, and that's the side that you're gonna put down into the chamber. Now this is where you're going to use your packer. Make sure that's all the way down there. Now you're gonna cook this for about 6 to 8 minutes, and then your party is ready for the barbecue pork rolli. For a great lunch the kids will love, try the ham and Swiss rolli or cheddar turkey rolli. Using 1 piece of crescent roll dough, spread with mayonnaise or mustard. I'm gonna use mustard on this one. And then you could add your ham and cheese. And you could also use 2 pieces of biscuit dough, smoked turkey, and cheddar cheese. Now, starting with the large end, roll the dough all the way down. Keep it kind of small and tight. And then you're gonna just take the 2 ends and pinch them. Now you take your dough and you put it into the cooking chamber. And then use the packer to make sure it is all the way down into the chamber. Now cook this for about 8 to 10 minutes. And you're all set. You have the perfect snack for the kids. Ham and Swiss rolli or a cheddar turkey rolli. Another great snack for the kids is the PB&J rolli. Lay out 1 piece of crescent roll dough onto a flat surface and then spread with 1 tablespoon each of peanut butter and jelly. There we go. Now you're going to roll the dough, start with the larger end, roll all the way down, keeping it pretty tight. And then once you roll it all the way down, you're going to just pinch the edges, and you're going to put this into the cooking chamber. And you can use your packing stick just in case it doesn't get all the way down into the chamber. Now you're going to cook this for about 10 minutes. Now a good note to know is that the dough should be cold. And this is going to make it a lot easier to work with. If you let it sit out and get warm, it's going to be a little difficult to work with. There you have it, the perfect snack for the kids, PB&J rolli. For a grown-up lunch, how about a Cuban rolli? Cut a tortilla into a 4x6 rectangle, then spread some mustard in the middle. And then you're gonna add 1 piece of ham, 1 piece of roasted pork, a slice of Swiss cheese, and some pickles. Now you're going to take your tortilla and roll it up. Roll it up really tight. Then you're going to take this and put it into the cooking chamber. And you're gonna cook this for about 6 to 8 minutes and then pour the product out. And there you have it, the perfect grown-up lunch, the Cuban Rolly. Or how about a tuna melt Rolly? Start with 2 pieces of biscuit dough, rolling it out flat into a 3 to 4 inch circle. Place 2 tablespoons of your favorite tuna salad inside. And then a half a slice of sharp cheddar cheese on top. Now you're gonna roll the biscuit dough tightly together. And then you're gonna pinch the sides and then put that into the cooking chamber. And just make sure your tuna melt is all the way into the chamber. Now instead of a biscuit dough, you can also do this with a tortilla, cutting it into a 4x6 rectangle. Cook this for 6 to 8 minutes and then you have the perfect tuna melt Rolly. If you're looking for a great party snack, try the vegetable egg Rolly. In a bowl, mix 1/4 cup of thinly sliced cabbage and 1/4 cup of matchstick carrots and 1/4 teaspoon of ginger and 1 teaspoon of oyster sauce. Mix that all together. And then we're going to place that into our wonton. We're going to roll up our wonton and roll it pretty tight. That way it will fit into the cooking chamber. And then just take your wonton and put it right in there. Cook for approximately 6 to 8 minutes and then pour the vegetable egg Rolly out. If you like a crispier crust, you can turn your Rolly upside down and place it back into the Rolly cooker for about 2 minutes. Then you have the perfect party snack. Or try the Rolly Burger Dog. Start with 1/2 pound beef. We suggest using a 20% fat content. Mix in some cumin, salt and pepper, some parsley, and some onion. And then really you can mix in whatever flavors you like. If you're a garlic lover, go ahead and throw in some garlic. There we go. Now mix this all together. And then we're going to take this out and we're going to roll up into a meatball. Just take a little bit. Roll it up into a meatball and then we're going to roll it into a tube to fit into the cooking chamber. Make sure it's packed pretty well, so it'll go into the chamber. Perfect. And then go ahead and place that into the chamber. You could insert a wooden skewer into the burger so that it's a little easier to remove after cooking. Now cook for 6 minutes if you want your burger medium and 7 to 8 minutes if you want your burger well done. There you go, a fantastic Rolly Burger Dog. Now for something sweet. Check out this delicious chocolate banana Rolly. Lay 1 piece of crescent dough onto a flat surface and spread 1 tablespoon of chocolate hazelnut. Then add a few slices of bananas, or you can use strawberries if you wish. Now you're going to roll up the crescent dough starting at the large end. And make sure you fold the sides when it's all the way rolled. Perfect. Then roll it thin enough to fit into the cooking chamber and then cook for 10 minutes. And make sure that the dough is cold when you do this and don't let it sit out and get too warm because it's going to be difficult to work with. Then you have a perfect chocolate banana Rolly. And for an anytime snack, try the cinnamon Rolly. Take 1 piece of refrigerated pre-made cinnamon roll dough and roll it into a tube. Then from here, all you have to do is put it into the cooking chamber and cook it for about 8 minutes. When it's ready, some drizzle, some frosting, and that's it. Yum! Here are some useful tips for your Rolly Egg Master. The red light will indicate power is on. When the green light turns on for the very first time, the Rolly is ready to use. The green light will turn on and off during use. Be sure to use non-stick oil spray before each use. It is recommended to insert a wooden skewer in the center of the filled cooking chamber to assist with easy removal of the product. Or if you don't have a wooden skewer, just tilt the rolly over and pour it right out onto a plate. Use the provided packer to push down the product while filling the cooking chamber. If the product begins to rise out of the cooking chamber, pour the product onto a plate to avoid the product from flopping over after rising completely. After removal of the product, you may turn the product upside down and reinsert into the cooking chamber for about 2 minutes for a crisper finish. Clean the cooking chamber between each use of different recipes. Enjoy and get creative with all the wonderful recipes you can create with your Rolly Egg Master.